and welcome to a brand new episode of Celeb Talk. Today I have a beautiful starlet of Sandalwood. She's known for her movies Sajni, Krishna, Navagraha, and most recently, Aake. Let's talk to Sharmiela Mandre today. Very glad to have you here.
It's a pleasure being here. Thank
How
you
are
very
you?
Much. Very well, thank you.
All right. So let's see what her experience was so far in the Sandalwood industry. Where she's going to take her career from here post Aake. So Sharmiela, nothing new about Sandalwood to you,
nothing new, yeah.
Yeah, you were born and brought up in a family which is very closely related to Sandalwood.
Correct.
So tell us about your background.
My background, I would say that I come from a film family. Right from my grandfather who started distributing as well as producing films, and which my dad took over, and then my uncle started producing films. So it's basically always been behind the camera, and right. I think I was the only one. They were pretty shocked initially when I kind of told them that I want to get into the industry, because they thought I would want to do something behind the camera, like production or distribution. But when I actually told them that I wanted to act, then it did come as a certain amount of surprise to them.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you're one of three siblings?
Three siblings. I'm the youngest, yeah.
Were you pampered?
Actually, I was the least pampered. My eldest sister, the first born in the family, was the most pampered because she was the most prized, the first child in the house and everything. So she was pampered a lot. And then my brother, of course, because then there was the first boy again. And then there was me. So it was like, okay, by then the two kids have already kind of got all the attention from the family, and I wasn't kind of, it's not like I wasn't treated very well, but having said that, I wasn't pampered like the way my siblings were.
Yeah, all the pampering was done.
Already, yeah. By the time the third kid came, everyone was like, okay,
they were tired.
Yeah.
Okay. So, tomboy you wear, right? You wear a tomboy.
Quite a tomboy, yeah.
Absolute. So, yeah. What are the pranks you've played?
Actually, I was quite a chubby little kid with very, very short hair. And it was actually my mum who used to always go and get my hair cut at the salon, and I used to cry because I was quite, like, I wanted long hair, you know. And
story of every young girl who has short hair.
Yeah, and then in the salon, they would have only two, haircuts. They'd either be a mushroom cut or it would be like a wedge cut or something like that. And I used to be like, oh my god, I don't want either, you know. And literally, I used to cry. They used to literally drag me to the salon. But it was really torturous to get my hair cut. But obviously, as I grew older, then I grew my hair and I was like at peace. But yeah, I was a typical tomboy. I mean, I would only be living in shorts and t-shirts and, you know, hanging with the boys in the house, and especially my brother and all his friends. And we would play every day, and I would never do any girly things. Like, people would buy me Barbies for my birthday and I would probably play with it for like a day, and then the next day it would be out the window. Like, it would be like a fight or something between me and my brother, and it would be damaged like in a matter of 24 hours.
Okay.
So, yeah. It was quite a crazy childhood that way.
Have you played any pranks?
Actually, my brothers played a lot of pranks on me because I was always the youngest girl. So he used to like play so many pranks on me all the time, you know. So it was a crazy childhood that way in terms of playing pranks. But of course, I've also played a lot of pranks on people. I used to scare people a lot. Like, every time somebody came, I would go and stand behind a wall or something, and when they came, I used to be like scare them suddenly, and they used to all get like frightened and stuff like that.
Those things that kids do.
Yeah.
Okay. Your favorite food is cakes. Chocolate.
No, actually I'm not much of a chocolate person, but I'm a big, big foodie. Like, food is something, I think before coming here I even told you that the place we are at is like one of my favorite restaurants. Because for me, food is very integral. I mean, I know an actor saying this is quite rare, because usually they say actors are always on diets. Yeah. But for me, food is very essential. Ever since I was a kid, as I told you, I was quite a heavy child, right? So for me, it was never about dieting. Even for me to lose all that weight, it took some time, but I always was on a very healthy diet. So for me, food is extremely important. Like, I like good quality food, like different cuisines and everything. So it can be right from continental to Chinese, to Pan-Asian, to Mexican, to Indian. So yeah, I mean, for
me, tried your hand at cooking?
I have, because since I'm such a foodie, I have to like obviously try cooking. I do bake a lot. Mm-hmm. I started baking at a very young age. I started baking cookies and cakes and stuff like that. So I love baking. And apart from that, now, of lately, I've started cooking my own food sometimes, my own meals, especially when I'm traveling. Because when I'm traveling on work, what happens is you know, Arfa, I tend to eat too much outside food. And yeah. when you come back, you get so fed up. And people are like, you're staying in a hotel, so hotel food is amazing. And I'm like, you know what? You can do it once, you can do it twice. But then when you do it every day, it gets so boring after some time. And then when you know the menus by heart, then you know that you had too much of hotel food. So, you know, I've started cooking my own food where, you know, it involves not very high carbs, low carbs, high protein, high fiber diets.
Healthy food.
Healthy food, yeah.
Fantastic.
Yeah. And but tasty at the same time. For me, my taste buds are very, very sensitive. Like, I need to have tasty food.
Oh, yeah. She's got certain requirements as yeah. far as food is concerned. Okay.
Yes.
All right. Sharmiela, are you a sporty person? Have you always been into sports?
Actually, I'm the most non-sporty person you can ever find.
Come on, you're so fit. How can you be non-sporty?
You won't believe it. Like, people come and like tell me things like, you know, let's go for this cricket match and we have like these amazing tickets. And I'm like, what am I going to do in a cricket match? Because I honestly, I'm the only person I think in India who doesn't follow cricket. Because I mean, I'm just not sporty, you know.
Okay. You played a lot of cricket when you were young.
When I was young with my brother, yeah. But that was like the typical gully cricket, like they say, you know, that kind of a thing. And of course, I played a lot of badminton as well. Mm. Apart from these two sports, not much.
But how do you keep fit? I mean, you look fabulous in person. I must tell you, she looks gorgeous in person. Not as that much justice done by cameras, okay? So you're really fit, okay? So how do you maintain yourself? Do you have a routine like gym?
I do. See, the thing is, I told you earlier, I love food so much. I can never compromise on food. But having said that, I also try and keep myself fit by doing a lot of yoga and I go to the gym. The gym can get a little boring. So what I do is I kind of plan out my own workouts wherein I introduce new exercises every day in the gym. I don't do the regular stuff in the gym like running or the cross trainer. I do other stuff like circuit training and functional. So that way it interests me as well and I don't get bored and it gets you addicted to the whole routine. So
okay.
That's how I like to work out.
You're not a yoga person?
I do a lot of yoga as well. I think I do yoga more so because of the fact that it gives me a lot of peace of mind and a lot of meditation, a lot of breathing techniques. That's what I concentrate on a lot. Yeah.
Okay, super.
I think every actor needs to do yoga.
Yeah.
Just to get a little more de-stressed in life, yeah.
And also to wean off that character you're playing, I think.
Yeah.
I think it will really help.
Yeah, you need that calming factor. Mm-hmm. I mean, you have 24 hours in a day out of which you're working for 12 hours. You need that 1 hour of uninterrupted, meditation where you're just calm and your mind is very kind of de-stressed, for sure.
Right. So she's also big time into traveling around the world. Your family and you love to travel, right?
Yes, I do.
So tell us your favorite destination.
I have tons of destinations which I love. Like there's nothing in particular, but I just love, I'm a nomad. Like I just want to try, I just keep traveling to different destinations. And I make it, I think all my money that I earn through films, I just spend on traveling, which is very bad because people say you must save and stuff like that. But I just love traveling because I think it's just about going to different cities and experiencing new places, new cuisines, everything new, you know. So I try and make at least one trip a year to a destination which I've never traveled to before.
Okay, the wandering soul there for you,
yeah,
Sharmiela Mandre. Okay, so when did the acting bug bite you really?
I think I've always been very, very interested in acting, right from a young kid. For me, my biggest, like, I know this might sound very cliche, but as a kid, I was very, very obsessed, I would say, with films.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe because I was also born into the whole thing. I would go for shootings, like whatever films my family would produce, or, you know, they would have friends who would produce films in the industry. And I would keep going for so many film shoots. And I was so in awe of the whole setup of a film set. And, you know, also to watch films. Like, I would go, I still remember, like my mum would always like blackmail me. She would be like, you should study and finish all your homework by Saturday. So that Saturday afternoon, the matinee show, I would take you, I'm going to take you for the film,
oh,
you know.
Okay.
So that's the only way she would get me to study.
Uh-huh.
And I would go to a film theater and watch these films. And especially when the opening credits would come, I would visualize myself probably being there one day.
Wow.
And it was always a childhood dream for me to kind of get into films.
Okay.
I always wanted to do it.
But then, yeah. Even though you were offered your first movie at the age of 16, like a very tender age, yeah?
Very, very young age.
Very young. But then your family said, nope, you're studying.
Yeah.
And then what happened? You went for a training.
So basically, I finished my education. In Bangalore, I studied in Mount Carmel College. And even before the results were out, I was in London on a holiday because I'd finished, you know, my exams and everything. And over there, I got my results and I actually passed with flying colors. Like, I got 97%. And my parents are like, now start applying for law colleges.
Okay.
Because they thought that would be my option of, you know, career. Because that was also on my mind, quite honestly. But then, you know, something told me, I was doing a lot of theater, I was doing a lot of I was very active in my dance associations and a lot of dance schools. So I always thought that I want to kind of get into this line, but I just didn't know how to break it to them. And when I finally told them that I want to stay back and kind of do a proper full-fledged acting course, they kind of were quite shocked. They're like, why don't you come back to Bangalore, get into law school and do this, you know, simultaneously? Okay. Why can't you do two things at the same time? But I said, that's not what I want to do. I really want to get into this full time, you know. And initially they were a little hesitant, but eventually they kind of got used to the
they
idea
bunched.
Of me. Yeah, they bunched. And then, that's how I kind of started, acting, and I did an acting course there, and then my first film started.
Does it help? I mean, acting, to have fame, does it really help?
Definitely, Arfa, definitely. See, there are two things to it. Acting should definitely be a talent that you already possess. The acting school will only help you get better at what you have. Right? Like, for instance, a cricketer is good at cricket because he has an inborn talent, but obviously he gets coaching or trained and, you know, improves his skill. So the same way with acting, right? You kind of have that talent, and then acting lessons will only make you get better and more comfortable in front of a camera or in front of an audience.
Right, the technicalities are...
The technicalities important. Are very important because acting in, I used to do a lot of theatre, so acting in front of an audience and acting in front of a camera is extremely different. They're too different because in a theatre it's an audience and the smallest flaws will not be able to be
correct.
Judged.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas on camera, everything is in your face. Right?
So you actually got trained in Kathak.
Yes.
Right? So, and then you went on to judge a dance
reality show. Yeah.
Wonderful. So tell us about how you got into Kathak and stuff.
So, when I was a kid, I was extremely passionate about dancing. At the age of 3, my mom realized that passion and she started sending me for Bharatanatyam classes for like a couple of months, and then I shifted to Western dance. So I was always like, you know, Western, Indian, Western. I did a lot of forms of dance, and I did salsa, I did merengue, I did tap dance, I did, you name it, I've done all forms of dances. And my favorite would be jazz ballet.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because it comes very, and contemporary form of dance is also something I really like. Then after that, I got into a dance association in school, then in college. Then it took up a lot of my time because most of the time I was always associated with dance. But having said that, it's always been a passion that I truly enjoy doing, right? And and then my mom's like, okay, since you're serious about it, let you do all the classes and then move forward and stuff like that. Yeah.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
And then how did Sajni happen? The launch pad.
Yeah, Sajni, of course, I was off after I started doing my acting lessons in London. I was approached to do a lot of films in Kannada at that point.
Your focus was on Kannada industry, Sandalwood? Was it a natural choice, I mean?
I mean, I think everybody, when they approached me from the Kannada industry more so because they knew I was interested in doing films, and also because they had known me since childhood, right? So they knew that this whole thing was happening. But I had nothing, I mean, there was no specification that I want to do a film here or thing. It was just something I always enjoyed doing. My first film happened because I was extremely passionate about doing films. But having said that, I wanted a good film to be launched by, you know, I didn't want to do any film.
Yeah.
And of course, it was a home production, and Sajni happened right then and there.
And you had a wonderful experience doing
yes.
that, yeah? Okay, so after Sajni, you went on to do movies like Krishna, Navagraha, etc., right? So different roles, you enjoyed doing them. Which was the most, experience-wise?
Challenging.
Yeah, which was challenging or let's say memorable?
Sajni was very close to my character in person because as a person, I'm extremely energetic, I'm very outgoing. So it was very close to what I am in person. So for me, it wasn't much of an effort. But obviously, facing a camera for the first time was a little bit of nervousness is obviously there. But the real challenge came in my second film, Krishna, because in that film they offered me a role opposite Ganesh, and that role was that of a village girl, and obviously, you know, me being me was not very well versed at, you know, portraying that character. So I was very, very nervous doing that role because I was like, I don't want to make a fool of myself. I don't want people to look at me as something I may not look okay doing. So obviously I went to this place called Chitradurga where we were shooting, and there were a lot of girls there. I interacted a lot with them. It was actually my director MD Sridhar who really got me into the crux of the role. He told me how my body language should be, how it should be different, what my negative points were and what my positive points were, and how I could change that to in accordance with the role. And I actually honestly never expected to look the way I did in the film, thanks obviously to my director who really portrayed me very nicely, and that was one role which was really appreciated by a lot of people. Of course I was very nervous working with my co-star because at that point he had done Mungaru Malai, which was the biggest success, and this was his film right after, so obviously people are all going to rush to watch this film, so I really really didn't want to make a fool of myself. But honestly, that character was really, really appreciated, and it took my career to the next level. So
wonderful. Yeah. But you're in no hurry to, you know, sign movies. Sign books, looks like. What is the funda behind it?
See, you know, I'm honestly very, very. I mean, this might sound weird, but my name is Sharmiela, and it means shy. And everyone says it's a misnomer because I'm not that shy because I'm in the film industry. But actually, it is true because I'm quite shy. I'm quite an quite a introvert, I would say. I don't believe in networking. I don't go out there. I don't put myself out there. In fact, even for my promotions, so only when a film of mine releases, I come out and promote the film. Otherwise, I'm quite MIA. You know, I'm always not in the limelight. And a lot of people say you're not even controversial. In all the years that I've been in the industry, I've honestly not had a single controversy, touch wood. Not because of anything else, but I'm quite the loner. I mean, I'm quite outgoing, but having said that, I mean, I like my hanging with my family and my set of friends, but I'm not the person who goes out there and says, okay, here I am, you know, here I'm, like, hello, what's up and everything. So for me, it's always been, even with films, it's always been if I'm comfortable doing the film, if the role is good, if it's something I'm you know, enjoying, then I do it. Because for me, acting has always been it's been very passionate. It's been a passionate profession for me.
Yeah.
I've never gone out there and said, okay, for me, I have to take this seriously. For me, so yeah, that's why I've always taken my projects very slowly. I've never been in a rush. I'm in no rat race of doing 10 films a year and stuff like that.
Right. So for the comfort zone that you're looking for while signing roles, you know, the thing about getting a character in a movie is that it removes you from your own
personality
and you have to adapt to another character and person in the script that's
script,
given.
Yeah.
So how did K.M. Chaitanya actually convince you to take up a role which is not even your age?
You're slightly more mature.
Mother, what did he tell you to convince you, and why do you think he chose you?
Arfa, I honestly believe that me as a person, when I'm in front of a camera, I don't know what happens. I become somebody else, right? When off camera, okay, I'm something. But when I'm in front of a camera, given a role, for me, I try my level best to get into the crux of the character. And when Chaitanya sir offered me this film, it was honestly very, very overwhelming for me because he narrated the subject, and it was a dream come true role, I would say, because it was a very, very challenging role for a girl, because the protagonist of the film is the girl, and even the title, as you see, Aake, is based on the girl. So, you know, it was very, very overwhelming because I felt like, okay, this is like the most amazing role a person can get, like, you know, but I was very, very apprehensive as to how I'm going to convince the audience with this role, and obviously I have to do that only through my acting. And I was very, very happy he considered me for this role, and there are so many talented actresses out there. I mean, he could have chosen anyone, but he did choose me, and I felt I need to do justice to the role. I mean, he needs to feel that he did the right choice kind of approaching me. So I really gave it my 100%, and I'm very happy that a lot of people have appreciated the work that I've done in this film.
You actually went through workshops.
Yes.
So tell us about that.
The workshops were very, very vigorous, I would say, because Chaitanya sir comes from a theatre background where he believes that every single actor in his film have to be very well versed, has to know the script in and out, and their dialogues. Each character should know their dialogues by heart even before we start shooting. So he and Mr. Prakash Belwadi, these two people helped me a lot to train for my role, because as you said, it was a role where I had to play a mother, which was much older than what I am, a very mature character. Firstly, I'm you know, the whole body language of being a mother is very tough. Because, you know, it changes, because, you know, how you hold your own baby is very different from how a normal person would hold somebody else's baby. That, the way you talk, your gestures, you know, the way you kind of say your dialogues, everything changes, you know, with your character. And they really, really helped me a lot. For about 15 days, morning to evening, I was just sitting with them non-stop, working on every scene possible. On all the dialogues, and it was honestly very vigorous, but it was fun in the process. It was very challenging for me, you know. I love taking up challenges, because for me it's always about people. When they watch a film, it's not about, you should convince, an actor should be so convincing that when a person sees you on screen, they have to kind of believe that this is a true character,
true.
Right?
Yes.
If you can't believe that you can do it, then the audience will not.
Will not.
So, yeah, that's what it is. So I'm very happy he kind of selected me for this film.
Wonderful. Vigorous promotions going on for Aake. Literally, you've taken time out from an interview herself. So, wonderful. I wish you more luck. I mean, after Aake's success, I really wish that you get brilliant roles and, you know, happen to do some memorable characters, let's say. You also venture into Tamil movie
Tamil
industry.
And Telugu. Yeah.
And Telugu. So, next comes Bollywood, I guess.
Bollywood, yeah.
Anything coming up?
I have Katha coming up. It's a film directed by Khalid Mohammed. It's a remake of a 1983 classic called Katha, which had Deepthi Naval and Nasruddin Shah. Again, there I need to fill in the shoes of Deepthi Naval, who's such a versatile actress. So for me to kind of, I mean, it's all a challenge, like I said, like for me to get into her shoes and to be, I'm sure there will always be a comparison, but I feel like I need to really prove myself with that film. Yeah.
Okay, okay. So when you look back in time, okay, from the time you started into the film industry to now, have you changed a lot?
Definitely. I think the industry really teaches you so much. Like it makes you a very patient person, I would say, because films, whether it's signing films or doing films or waiting for the release of the film, it's all about patience and waiting. Like waiting, like you're sitting on at shoot, you're waiting all day, like for your shot to be taken. You're waiting for your film release. You're waiting for a good film to come your way. So it's all a waiting game. So it teaches you a lot of patience. Of course, you become a, it's not by choice, but you become a people's person, because you get opportunities to meet so many different kinds of people every single day. Like you meet so many new people. So that is a lovely new experience. Before I joined the industry, I don't think I was such a social person in the sense, like I wouldn't, I mean, like I said, I was an introvert. I wouldn't be out there meeting people, but now it doesn't take too much for me to kind of meet people. So,
right, wonderful. So you had a role, like you know, with Chiranjeevi Sarja.
Yes.
So what kind of a person is he?
Oh my
he
God,
seems
he's a prankster, by the way. He seems very calm and very quiet, but he's such a huge prankster.
Is
like,
he?
Yeah, he would like literally make so much fun of me and Chai on sets, like Chaitanya sir, because he, first of all, especially with Chaitanya sir, because he's worked with him before and he's doing another film with him now. So he always has this rapport with him. So first of all, Chaitanya sir has this problem of getting tickled all the time. So he would go and purposely tickle him on the sets and make fun of him and go and scare him and scare me in the bargain.
Okay.
Like, he's a big, big prankster on sets, yeah.
And
he was like the stress buster on sets, because we were all very serious. Like, I was so involved in like the role, like, you know, you got to be serious all the time and mature, and even Chaitanya was very like serious. But when Chiranjeevi came on sets, it was like, it was havoc.
Okay. So that was about Sarja for you. So what did you learn from Chaitanya? Is he a taskmaster?
He is a taskmaster. I hope he's not seeing this interview.
I'm making sure he's seeing this.
But yeah, he's a taskmaster, and for him, off, you know, when you're not shooting, do what you want. You want to go have fun, you want to make fun, you want to go out, do whatever you want. But when you're on set, I want you to be in character. And like, he's very serious like that about everything. So I was also very much, you know, into the whole role, because he was extremely sure about what he wanted. Like, he's very specific. He's a huge taskmaster. And when you see people like this around you, you want to also you know, live up to his expectations of him as an actor. So, I mean, I think that's very good for actors in a way, because sometimes directors are like, okay, go ahead and do what you think is not natural. But he will always help you kind of, you know, better yourself as an actor, which is what we should all have as a director.
And that's wonderful.
Yeah.
So what do you have to say about Prakash Belwadi?
He looks so serious. So basically, Prakash, I've seen all his Hindi films, right? Yeah. Like I've seen.
I loved his character.
Airlift. Yeah, I loved his character, and you won't believe it. When I saw Airlift, I didn't know him at that point, but when I saw it, I was like, this guy really stands out in the film.
He actually gets.
Yeah, he doesn't have like a huge role, but then he's something that remains in your head like after you watch the film. So when I actually met him, I was like, oh my god, like he might be as strict like the way he was in Airlift. So I'm like. Like, you know, I met him on the first day of the workshop, so I was like very well behaved, and I'm like, yes sir, yes sir. And then he's like, why are you so serious? Like what's why are you being so serious? And I'm like, no, I'm just trying to, you know, behave myself. He's like, listen, you don't have to behave yourself around me, and don't have these preconceived notions about me, because I'm just not the way you think I am. And he's actually such a fun person. He's so humorous. Like he will start at the drop of a hat, he'll just crack a joke and everyone will be very serious and suddenly burst into laughter after he cracks a joke. And he's actually very humorous. Like, I love that about him. And he's very light. Like, he takes everything very light. He's like, don't stress. Like, you know, as an actor, you need to kind of let go of your inhibitions and just kind of be yourself. And, you know, he's a very relaxed person to work around.
So you really had a good team who were encouraging you.
Very, very encouraging. And I think that's very important, especially Arfa, because, you know, when we make films, you always want support from your co-actors.
Yes.
There are so many actors who will be like, okay, you know, do what you have to do and I'm doing my own thing. But when you're surrounded by people, especially theatre actors, because they're very involved in every single aspect of filmmaking, so they will help you out, like Prakash Belwadi and even Chaitanya sir, obviously. They were, at every step of the way, they were very supportive in whatever I did, which was absolutely wonderful.
Superb. So after Aake, you're going on to do a movie called Leader.
Yes.
Right? So tell us about it.
It's my first film with Shivraj Kumar and...
There you go. Shivraj Kumar. Next. Yeah.
So I've always heard very, very good things about him, but this was my first hand experience working with him. I went on the set the first day. I was shooting simultaneously for Aake at that point. When I went on sets the first day, I was nervous because I'm like, I'm working with such a huge star, right? So I got to be serious. And then he was just like, okay, and I had to, and my first scene with him was this huge dialogue which was 2 pages long, right?
Okay.
And they just come and give me the dialogue. They're like, you know Kannada, right? So just say the dialogue. I'm like, yeah, but you should give me some time to prepare, because, you know, I can't just say anything in front of him. He's going to think I'm like a bad actor or something like that. So then they're like, no, relax, it's fine. So I actually went and I started, like, my first shot with him, I was actually blabbering because I was so nervous too. Like I knew the dialogue, but I was just so nervous around him. And then he's like, why, don't be nervous, like just say it in your own way, like how you would say it normally. And he made me feel very comfortable, and then after that it just came out naturally. And I just thought to myself, he's such a down-to-earth actor, and like he has no qualms of helping you out with your dialogues or your scenes. And one would not think that, you know, such a big star would like be so down-to-earth.
When is it coming out?
It's slated to release on the week prior to Independence Day. That's August 11th. So,
okay. So are we going to get a peekaboo about the storyline at all?
It's a political. It's a political film. It got to do a lot with the entire government and this and that. The film is my role in the film. Basically, is that of a journalist. I play a journalist who has a very strong and pivotal character in the film, which takes the film forward. And I have a very nice song in the film. The journalist goes undercover, and then she goes into this environment where they have a lot of belly dancers and stuff like that. So I guess, that's what I can say about the film.
All right.
As of now.
Okay, wish you good luck for that.
Thank you so much.
Okay. One thing about Sharmiela Mandre that everyone wants to know is, are you single?
I'm single. I mean, I know this sounds really cliche, because every actress in the world, not in the world, but at least in India, would say we're single, but I'm actually single. And I'm so proud to say that, because at least now people will know I'm single, so, you know.
So you're going to have offers soon.
Yeah,
are you keen?
This is like an ad for, you know, like they have that wedding
matrimonial. I don't want to be single anymore.
Right?
Yeah, that's true. Okay, so what do you look for in a relationship?
In a relationship, I obviously look for a person who is very hardworking, who understands me as a person, because I, as much as I seem very normal, I think I'm quite complicated that way. Because I'm quite like, you know, I like to talk a lot, and especially with, you know, if he's going to be my other half, like I would like to share a lot of things with him. Hardworking, I said. And of course, humorous as well. You got to take light of a lot of situations. You can't have a very, very strict person or somebody very serious in your life.
You like to laugh.
I love laughing, yeah, a lot.
But are you a funny person? I am.
I crack
laugh.
Jokes all the time. People actually relate. Especially my close friends, they always think I'm such a prankster. Whenever you won't believe, whenever they're depressed or upset about something, they call me up and they're like, let's meet. Because they feel that I'm going to think. I'm like, but who's going to do that for me? Like, if I'm upset, who do I call, you know?
There you go. Yeah. You better be funny if you want to be
yeah,
in my
exactly.
life. So I'm going to take you through a quick round of, let's say, a quick fire. Okay, you have only like 5 seconds to answer to the questions I ask you. All right, you good to go?
Yes, I'm good to go.
There you go. So, 3 words to describe Sharmiela Mandre.
Funny, spontaneous, and a big foodie.
Foodie?
Yeah.
Okay, funny, yeah. Spontaneous, foodie. All right, and your favorite food?
Okay, speaking of food, I don't have anything in particular, but I love experimenting with cuisine. So I like Moroccan, I like Mexican, I love Chinese, Pan Asian.
She's actually covering the whole.
Yeah, everything. Like I honestly don't like. You will know this because a foodie never likes only one particular
yeah.
food. They like a variety of food.
But do you have a sweet tooth?
Not really. Not
chocolates
as much.
Chocolates don't impress you.
I prefer cookies, like chocolate chip cookies or something like
okay,
that.
So,
yeah. So not cakes as much.
Okay. So if a guy has to impress you, you know, make the first impression. What should he do?
Well, with food.
Uh huh.
Just get me a great meal. Like we should go out
anything,
for a game.
Nothing like chocolates only.
No, no, nothing.
Cookies only.
No, that's very cliche, no? Flowers and chocolates. I think
yeah.
every girl gets that. And it's very like, I don't want to expect something which is already done 100 times before with everybody else, right?
Okay, what would help something. Like, would, what else apart from a good food?
I think the way he would, uh-huh. he should impress me. I think a great conversation, right?
Yeah, funny conversation.
A funny conversation.
She loves to laugh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think who doesn't, right? Every girl
yeah.
loves a man with a
girls
great
love to laugh.
Yeah,
yeah isn't it?
Yeah.
We do.
And gossip.
Do you gossip?
I mean, I would be lying if I say I don't.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, I think.
What do you gossip about? Like,
especially with my girlfriends, like when me and my girlfriends meet, the only thing they talk about is like, oh my god, that girl wore that dress and it didn't look nice on her.
Wait. It can't be a girl. It has to be an actor or an actress, right?
No, my friends don't really talk. Yeah, I mean, we talk
yeah,
about
do
actresses.
Do you talk about actresses?
Of course, like all the time.
Okay, are they really friends in Sandalwood?
I swear to God, I mean, this is quite, I'm just being honest. I have a lot of friends who are girls in the industry. I don't know what it is, and everyone's like, how can you be friends with an actress? Because that's so weird, like, you know, being friends.
Yeah,
because everybody has their own insecurities of films and this and that. And I'm like, no, but I actually get along with her, and I think she's a great person.
Uh-huh.
So I think that's a very it's a misconceived notion that people have.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So she's breaking some myths about the industry.
Yeah.
Okay, moving on to the next question. So, the naughtiest thing that you've done on sets, any sets?
Naughtiest thing, I think, has been, I've actually been very, this is really weird.
She's not naughty, she's thinking
yeah,
so much.
That's because I'm very well behaved on my set. Because, I mean, like I said earlier, off the set, I'm actually very like, you know, I go and do my
uh-huh.
crazy rubbish. But when I get on set, I'm always serious. In the sense, I'm very, very focused in my set.
So the
never done anything naughty.
Nothing. You're
no.
very professional.
Very professional. I swear I am. I am. Yeah.
And the most you've done is tickle KM Chaitanya.
Not me. That's Chiru. Yeah, Chiru is very bad on sets. Yeah. Like, he's really
okay.
Bad.
Okay. That's a darling on sets for you.
Yeah.
All right. So one thing that nobody knows about you.
Nobody knows about me that I'm an avid reader. I love reading.
Wow.
A lot, yeah. A lot of people think I don't read, but I actually do.
And who's your favorite author?
I know this is Nicholas Sparks.
Okay.
Because he has these
romantic, very mushy books that I love reading, and they even make films on those books, you know. I love his books.
Oh, she's romantic.
Yeah, of course.
Don't miss that. She's romantic.
Very romantic.
Okay, so a candlelight dinner would impress her.
Definitely.
A dinner, okay?
Okay.
And next one.
Dinner and great conversation.
A few laughs, good food, and romance.
And what a combo! You know what really turns me off in a guy, especially when they show off so much. That's something I hate.
Like, have you been through something like that?
Yeah, I have. That's what I'm saying.
Tell us.
No, because there are so many guys who are like, you know, we do this and we do that, and I'm like, don't tell me about what you do, because I really don't. I mean, about showing off. About, you probably can tell me what you do as a profession, but not go on and brag about your wealth or who you are as a person. You know, mm-hmm. I mean, if you're comfortable in what you are, you wouldn't be bragging about yourself.
Yeah, I guess. Show-offs don't speak, really. Yeah. So, if you want to nickname Prakash Belawadi, what would you
James
call
Bond.
Him?
James Bond. I call him James Bond. Because when he enters, like whenever we used to have workshops, everyone on the set calls him James Bond, by the way. Because when he walks in the set, he just walks, you know, in slow motion, like how James Bond walks. He creates this entire aura around him. And so whenever he comes, like for a workshop, even for shoot, he just walks, you know, very, like James Bond. So we just ended up calling him James Bond.
Okay, yeah. And you are...
And he even loves it. He loves the fact that we call him James Bond.
I can't imagine doing that.
Yeah.
So what's your nickname?
Oh, okay, this is really funny, but everyone calls me Chumpy.
Chumpy?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know why, that's really weird. But I mean, my explanation to the whole thing was, because it was just a nickname as from a childhood, which was given to me. Not like I chose it, but over a period of time, I think everybody in the industry started calling me that. And I'm like, okay, that's weird. So there was this recent interview I did, and they asked me this question as to why they call me Chumpy. So the host told me, he's like, in Telugu, champi means kill. Champestano, which means kill someone.
Kill.
So he's like, you're the kind of person who will probably kill someone someday.
No, she's got the killer looks. What more do you want?
Okay. Probably.
Yeah, I mean, that's a compliment.
I'll kill you with my eyes.
All right, what's the best compliment you've received?
Compliment. You know, compliments for me are not based. I don't get happy when people talk about my looks or the way I am, but I think if they compliment me about my film, like for Aake, I got so many compliments about my performance, that really makes me happy, that people appreciated my role in the film. So I take that as a huge, huge compliment.
Superb. Yeah. All right. One thing you should never do when Chiranjeevi Sarja is around.
Never do when he's around? Be serious, for sure. You can never be serious around him, or try and get into a mature role or a very serious role.
Please make sure that you will not be serious.
Yeah.
Okay. Your most memorable birthday cake.
Oh my God. I got this birthday cake when I was 4 or 5, which was a huge cake in the shape of a Barbie. So it was like massive. It was like a 3-tier cake, but there was like a Barbie, and then her dress, her gown was like huge, like, which was in the shape of a cake. So I think that was one cake I'll never forget, because I was so happy, because it was so big and so lovely.
Yeah, how much did you manage to eat?
I didn't eat, but I just wanted to show. I didn't eat
You're
as much. I was, but then I was so excited that all my friends are so happy to see my cake. I was just showing off with my cake.
Don't touch.
Yeah, just watch and see, but don't touch my beautiful cake. And my mom's like, no, don't do that. It's for them to eat. And I'm like, no, but then what happens to my lovely Barbie?
I know. Yeah, I mean, how can you destroy my Barbie?
Yeah.
All right. And do you watch TV a lot?
A lot. I'm like a TV addict. Like, there are times I sit at home, like I start watching TV at 9 a.m. And I stop at 9 p.m. It's called a potato couch, watch TV all day long.
Yeah. And considering you're so fit, I don't believe that.
Those are my days where I'm lazy. You know, you have those lazy days where you just want to sit with your pajamas and just watch TV and eat junk. Yeah, I have those days.
I'm not moving from this couch, matter what. Aaj mein, here is where I am.
Yeah.
So what's your favorite show on TV?
Oh my God, Game of Thrones. I love Game of Thrones, and this is my all-time favorite show. I don't miss a single episode. The day it's released, I'm the first one to watch it.
You don't like reality shows?
Reality, not so much. Yeah. I mean, yeah, I prefer TV shows.
You wouldn't want to join a reality show, take part in it.
I was a judge for a dance show, but I don't think I would be a part of a show where I'm involved as a contestant or something like that, yeah.
Right, okay. Yeah.
And your favorite movie?
Oh, there are so many. I like Scarface. I love horror movies. I love thriller movies. I have a whole list actually. Scarface, Godfather, so many, yeah.
Okay, so you are more inclined towards Hollywood.
And even, of course, Kannada as well as Hindi. So in Kannada, I liked all the old classics like Navagraha, Gejje Pooje, amongst the latest films, U-Turn, you know. And in Hindi, of course, there are so many old-time classics which I've always loved.
Any favorite actors, actresses?
In...
Anywhere.
Jennifer Lawrence in Hollywood. Actor in Kannada, I think there are so many beautiful actors here. There's Puneet Rajkumar, there's Sudeep. In Bombay, there's, in Bollywood, there's Aamir Khan, there's Salman Khan. I mean, yeah.
The Khan fan.
The Khan fan.
Okay, you met Shah Rukh Khan. I saw a clip of yours.
Yes.
Yeah? What was the experience like?
I actually met him as a kid once because we had a theatre-like thing and he had come to... There was a premiere of his film in our theatre when I was very young. So there was a photograph of me and him standing together and then I met him again about a year back. And it was lovely like to see him again. And the nicest thing was he hasn't changed one bit. Like in all these years, I've grown up, but he looks the same. That's remarkable,
lovely,
right?
Isn't it? Yeah.
Who looks the same after 20 years even?
That's wonderful. Yeah. So what's your dream role like?
My dream role is something that somebody hasn't done before. That you create a niche for yourself. You create a role which people love and enjoy. That would be like a dream role for me. Not something that somebody has already done. Mm. Yeah.
So what kind, like action or emotional?
See, Kangana Ranaut did Queen. That was a great film for her. That would be her dream role because she portrayed a role in a fresh way, in a new way. So that's her dream role. Something like that. Or even Jennifer Lawrence did this movie called Passengers. That was a good film. So, you know, everybody creates like their own films which they look and can be a dream role for them. So something like that. Action also is something I really like. Yeah,
I can actually imagine her doing some action, you know, shooting,
yeah, I would love
killing
to
people,
but
jumping.
It's actually so challenging to do an action role because it's quite tedious, physically very, you know, exhausting.
Yeah.
But that's the challenge, I guess.
I guess so.
Yeah.
All right. So moving on, what is your favorite thing about this city that you grew up in?
Weather. The weather is absolutely brilliant. I only understood the value of the weather when I started traveling, especially in other parts of India, because I would travel to Hyderabad, Chennai, Bombay, and then I realized, wow, Bangalore weather is the best, and I don't think I would want to shift anywhere else but Bangalore.
Seriously,
of course,
I vouch for that.
And the people, of course, the people are wonderful here, very relaxed, very chilled out, you know,
very accepting.
Yeah,
exactly. Yeah. If you had a superpower, you get a superpower, what would that be?
The invisible cloak.
Uh-huh.
It's a cloak that Harry Potter wears.
Yes.
Where he wears the cloak and he disappears. So I would want that cloak very badly.
Why?
Sometimes when you get into like embarrassing situations or you don't want to be somewhere, you just wear the cloak and you disappear.
you're not at all naughty. I don't need the cloak.
No, I need the cloak.
You do?
I really
you do,
do
embarrassing things?
I do very embarrassing things. So sometimes I just need the cloak and I just want to disappear from there. Or sometimes when I'm very exhausted and sometimes you're in a place where you don't want to be at, so then you wear the cloak and you disappear.
Poof.
Or with the cloak, you can walk into conversations where people don't want you to be there, but then you can listen to their conversations as to what they have in mind.
So, what are you talking about, me?
Yeah. Or anything. You get to know so much, right?
Right, okay. So, show us one weird or cool talent that you have.
Weird talent? I think my talent has always been acting and dancing. It hasn't been anything else.
Can you sing?
Yes, I can sing.
Yeah? Can you do that for us?
Okay.
Okay.
I can't help falling in love with you.
That's ooh. Okay, that was pretty neat. Yeah. That was neat. Thank you for that. Okay.
I'm actually a bathroom singer, but yeah.
A pretty good bathroom singer.
Yeah.
Okay. So what is that one habit you really need to break off from?
Habit? Asking too many questions.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I ask too many questions. Especially when I'm at work. All my directors get exhausted of me asking. They're like, when are you going to stop? I'm like, no, I want to know what's this, why, what's happening. So
the
that's
inquisitive Sharmiela.
No, I think it's just... Yeah, I guess it's inquisitive and I like to understand things on a more... Like, I don't like to leave things hanging. I want to know things properly so that especially understanding characters. So I asked too many questions. Okay. So in fact, there was this director, this film Navagraha I did. Darshan was my co-star and his brother Dinkar was the director.
Mm-hmm.
So after the film, we shot the film, he started calling me the doubt star. Because she always has doubts. She always has questions to
like
ask.
Like question marks all over you.
She has doubts in her mind all the time.
Okay.
So I'm going to call her the doubt star.
Okay.
Until today, he's like, do you still ask that many questions? I'm like, yes.
Alright, so, okay. And the most adventurous thing, I doubt you've done something like that.
Yeah,
but
I'm not adventurous. I'm a very boring person when it comes to adventure because I'm so scared. Like there was this one time a friend was like, let's go skydiving or let's go bungee jumping. And I'm like, never ever. Like I just can't do stuff like that.
I mean, for a person like that, you did a movie like Aake.
But I love horror.
You do?
I love the genre of horror. Like I don't know, I want to see it, but I don't want to see it. There are sometimes when I watch horror films, I'm putting in a mute.
Uh-huh.
So that those extra noises are not there, but I still want to watch the film. And I still get goosebumps all over.
Oh, that's like an adventurous thing you do?
That's not that adventurous.
Yeah, what have you done like?
I think ziplining is something, the max I've gone, I've done ziplining where they hang like this harness here and then you just go across.
Okay.
Like two like mountains, you know, you just go across. I think that's the most craziest thing I've done. And
that's
that for
scary.
Me is a lot. But that's not much as compared to like bungee uh-huh. jumping or skydiving because that is like a lot of height, right?
Whoa.
But here you just go across and in one shot and you're done. But I think that's the max I've ever done.
Nice, at least you did
and
something.
And after I swore I'm never going to do anything adventurous because it was very scary.
Yeah. Alright. Look, you've travelled all over the world. I would like you to say something in a foreign language.
Foreign language?
French? How many can you speak?
I mean, I'm not too, it's not like I know a lot in each language, but I can understand French. But apart from that, no other foreign language, I would say. Yeah.
And will you be able to say it like a French woman?
Je m'appelle Sharmiela and merci beaucoup for this show.
Oh, what did that mean?
It means my name is Sharmiela and thank you so much for calling me
oh,
for the show.
Oh, thank you very much for that.
Yeah.
Okay. Last but not the least, there was one funny incident with Achyut Kumar, your co-star from Aake.
Yes. So basically, Achyut Kumar and me have never worked on a film before except uh-huh. for Aake. And in the film, we didn't have any scenes together. Of course, he knew that I'm acting in the film and I knew he was acting in the film, but we had no scenes together. But of course, there was this other film where we were both approached for. So I went to meet the director and producer. While I was leaving, he was entering and I had told, and the producer and the director had told me that he's coming
uh-huh.
to meet them. So I had told both of them that, I mean, I'd worked with him and of course I know him because he's worked with me. I mean, he's worked in the same film as me. So while I was leaving, he entered and they introduced me to him and he's like, he had this expression in his face which was like, who is she? Like, and I'm like, and the director, they're like, don't you guys know each other? And he's like, he's still like very kind of blank and I'm like, I worked in the film that we were together in and he's like, oh my god, I'm so sorry and stuff like that. So yeah, that was my
funny.
Experience with him. But he's a wonderful person and he's a lovely actor. Like, he can really get into any character with so much ease and with so much of, you know, he has no inhibitions. He's very relaxed on sets and especially his acting is extremely good.
Yeah. All right. So Sharmiela, on that note, I would like to wish you good luck for your upcoming movies and
thank
all
you
your endeavors in the future, like not just in Sandalwood, also in Bollywood. Now we do know that you're a frequent visitor to this venue.
Yes.
Do you want to say something?
Definitely, Cafe Felix has been one of my latest favorite restaurants to come to, only because the food is amazing, the view is beautiful and they have great service. And of course, this mall is something that I think most Bangaloreans visit all the time because they have all the most nicest shops to shop at and they have a very nice food hall as well which I keep frequenting. So,
which is your favourite shopping, you know,
there's H&M
outlet.
And then there's MAC and then there's Marks and Spencer's. There's quite a few number of shops that most people
right.
would enjoy shopping at.
Alright, so thank you for coming over to 1MG Mall and giving us your precious time. Wish you all the best for your future. Thank you very much. Anything for YTV?
Thank you so much, YTV, for having me on the show, Celeb Talk. It was absolutely lovely talking to Arfa today. And I hope I can keep coming back to speak some more about my future films.
Yeah, why not? We would love to have you again. So on that note, thank you very much.
Thank you
for being with us on Celeb Talk. I'll see you next time with a new episode with a brand new star. You take care until then. This is Arfa Siddiqui signing off.